Hello, Batmites, and welcome to Battle for Zendikar pack openings. So, I went to the local card shop and got some booster packs. The card shop here does a deal of 3 for 10, so I got 9 for 30. I also got, in case I make a deck, some card sleeves. And I also got a deck box for a deck that I have made that doesn't have a deck box yet. So, let's start out by saying, again, long video. Don't like long videos, click away. What I do plan on doing, though, to make this a little shorter, I'm only going to show the uncommons, the rares, mythic rares, and foils. So, with that said, let's start out this little pack opening. Now, I, of course, will look at what I got because I'm interested in this shit. Ooh, I got some more allies. I got an ally deck that I have made. Ooh, okay. Some more Eldrazis. I got an Eldrazi deck. Okay. Another ally. Okay. So I got some stuff that I can refine my decks with. Another Eldrazi. Are we at the rares yet? No, we're not. I meant uncommons. And, okay. Another low drop landfall. It's not bad. Alright, now we're at the rares. And, I mean, uncommons and mythics. So, to start us off, we have Hagra Sharpshooter. It's a 3 drop with a 5 ability. Target creature gets minus one till the end of turn. 2/2. Oh, and just a fair warning, if I get an expedition land or a planeswalker, I'm gonna freak out. So we got Blighted Cataract. It's a land. Tap to add one colorless or spend 6 to draw 2 cards. Retreat to Emeria. It's got landfall. When a land enters the battlefield under your control, choose one. Put a 1/1 white core ally creature. Could go into my ally deck. Possibly. Or creatures I control get plus one till the end of turn. Not bad. Ooh. I have no idea how to say this. Goldrazz Overseer. It's flying 3/4 with landfall. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, other creatures you control get +1/+0 until the end of turn. If that land is a swamp, those creatures get +2/+0 till the end of turn. It's a nice card right there. It's expensive. But it's a nice one. Alright, and I just got a plane. And a ad. No one cares about ads. Alright. Whew. The planeswalker that I'm hoping for is Gideon. I'm wanting Gideon so bad. But if I get Obnixilis or whatever the other one is, I don't even know. I didn't spoil what was going to be in Battle for Zendikar, so I don't know everything. I can pretend I know everything, but I don't. Alright, some more Eldrazis, okay. Oh yeah, an outnumber with a fender, that's good. Beast with landfall. Oh. Devoid is good. I have one of those already. Okay, got one of those. So a bunch of colorless stuff, which is good. Elf warrior ally. Creatures you can get. I don't have this ally yet. It's a little expensive. I might not put them in. I'm not sure. Oh, yep, we're getting to the uncommons now. Alright, so we got Rot Shambler. Whenever another creature you control dies, put a 1/1 counter on it. It's pretty good. We have Ulamog's Nullifier. It's Eldrazi, the Void Flash, Flying, and when it enters the battlefield, you may put two cards your opponent owned from exile into their graveyard. If you do, counter target spell. Oh, well, Flash. That's what Flash is for. Alright, and it's a 2/3 creature. I might put this in. It's a good card for a 4-drop. I might put it in my Eldrazi deck. Alright. Encircling Fissure. Prevent all damage that would be dealt this turn by creatures target opponent controls. And then it has Awaken 2, which costs 4. And you would put 2/1/1 counters on a land and would become an elemental creature with haste. And it's still a land, though. So there's that. I don't know. I tend to not use those kind of cards, but I should probably start using those kind of cards. Oh, I think I've seen plenty of these. It's my rare. Wasteland Stranger. It's when it enters the battlefield, you may put a card opponent owns from exile to the graveyard. If you do, target creature gets -3/-3. So this is good. It's a good 3-drop. It's a 3/2. Not bad. I know my Eldrazis could use some lower drops because I have a 4-mana Eldrazi deck. Not working out too good. Oh, I've seen this card already. I actually have this card foiled already, too. It's an Orin Relief Invoker. You can spend 8, and you can put 5/+5/+5, and gains trample till the end of turn. Like I said, I've already seen this card, so this isn't really special to me. And I got a Swamp. And a Core Ally. It's not bad. Oh man, if I get a Planeswalker though. If I get a Planeswalker. Oh my god. Or an Expedition Land. I'm just so happy. I'm just biding my time right now. Okay, an instant. No. That would be useful. I might put that in one of my decks. I face. Because my Eldrazi and my ally deck doesn't really have anything that's good against flying. So I might put Plummet in one of those decks. Alright, I've already got you. Target opponent discards 2 cards. That could be good for my mill deck. Maybe. Human Warrior Ally. Oh, I already seen that one. Creatures you control gets +2/+1. Destroy target land. Yes. Volcanic Upheaval. That's a good one. You gain 1 life to tap this. I could see this card going into my life gain deck that I want to make. Right there. That's a good one. Are we at the... Nope, not yet. Eldrazi. Ingest. When it enters the battlefield, you control another colorless creature. Each one loses. That's going in my Eldrazi deck. The Dominator Drone. Yes, please. And this guy again. Yep. Alright, let's get to my uncommons and rares. We have Transgress the Mind. Target player reveals his or her hand. You choose a card from it with converted mana cost 3 or greater and exile that card. Oh yeah, that's going in one of my decks. I don't know which deck, but it's going in there. Definitely going in there. Yep. Probably my mill deck. Maybe. I don't know. Undo Rising. Whenever a creature attacks this turn, it gains lifelink until end of turn. So whenever a creature attacks, so any creature, I assume, correct me if I'm wrong, will gain lifelink until the end of turn. So this would be good for my lifelink deck. That's what it looks like. Did I show the last one? I showed the last one, I think. But just in case, there it is, that last one. So yeah, some good stuff so far. Where are we at? 10 minutes? Yeah, see, I told you. Long, long one. Alright, we got Crumble to Dust. Exile target non-basic land. Search its controller graveyard, hand, and library for any number of cards with the same name as that land and exile them. Then that player shuffles his or her library. Non-basic land. So now that's another thing that I'm a little confused about. Like, what is non-basic? Is it the stuff like Evolving Wilds, the dual lands? Is that non-basic? Let me know. And that's what it looks like. It's the Void, which would go good with my Eldrazi deck. Orin Relief Hydra, and this is my rare, has Trample and Landfall. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, put a 1/1 counter on Orin Relief Hydra. If that land is a forest, put two 1/1 counters, and it costs 6. It's not bad. And I got a swamp and an Eldrazi Scoring. My Eldrazi deck uses a lot of Scorings. That's for sure. I'm still waiting for that Planeswalker, though, or that Expedition. Still waiting for it. Alright. Elf Scout, and I'll counter on it. Each color mass spent. Ooh. I like this one. It's only the first card I'm looking at, and I like it. Yep. That's going in my ally deck, I think. Alright. Return target creature to hand. No. I already seen enough of these. It's a low drop though, so that'll help. Core Ally Scout. Okay. That's interesting. Elemental Landfall and Lander. Okay. A land. Oh, Evolving Wilds. I've seen plenty of these. Silent Skimmer. I've seen enough of these. Rush of Ice. I've seen this. Search your library for basic land, put it in the battlefield tapped, and shuffle the library. Okay. Having cards like Natural Connection, it's really good if you're trying to do more than two manas. Because my Eldrazi and my ally, well, my Eldrazi is 4 and my ally is 5, so that would be good for either deck. And we are at the uncommons now. Tunneling Geopede. Landfall. Whenever a land enters battlefield, deals 1 damage to each opponent. So man, imagine if I were to get 2 lands out in a turn. That'd be great. And there you go. Gotta make sure you see the card. Blighted Fen. It's a land. Can tap it to add a colorless or sacrifice it. Target opponent sacrifices a creature. Okay. And there's that. I feel like someone's gonna watch this video and be like, "Yo, you got an expensive card, man." Alright. Bane of Balagid. I've seen this. I've seen this already. I've got that in my Eldrazi, but I'm thinking of taking it out because it costs a lot. And the chances of me getting enough land to pay 7, very unlikely. Okay, this is a merfolk ally. I'm gonna butcher this name. Give me a minute. Noyan Dar Royal Shaper. So whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell, you may put 3/1/1 counters on a target land you control. The land becomes an elemental creature with haste, and it's still a land. That is interesting. So this could really just stack on lands, really. Like, I could cast an instant or sorcery, put a three 1/1s on a land, cast another one, put some more on that land. Or I can just give it all of my lands, just build an army of land soldiers. That'd be cool. All right. Ooh, and I got a foil. Fortified Rampart. The Fender 06. Nice. And a plains and a dragon. Dragon. Actually, true story. Well, it's not really a story, but true fact. Dragons are my favorite mythical creature. So far, no planeswalkers. I'm a little sad. All right. No planeswalkers or expeditions, actually. Oh yeah, this Eldrazi is definitely going in. Turn up the two creature cards from your graveyard to your hand. Eldrazi Drone. This is a one drop. Hey. When it dies, put a 1/1 colorless Eldrazi to the battlefield. Okay. Anticipate. I look at the three. Put a ribbon. Okay. Destroy land. That's always good. Yep. Gaining life. That's always good. I've seen that enough times to know what it does. I've seen that enough times to know what it does. Alright, what do you do? First strike, landfall. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, Undo Greenhorn gets +2/+2. Okay. Undo Champion. Minotaur Warrior Ally. Hello! Minotaur. I might put you in my Minotaur deck if you're good. Hey. Whenever a champion or an ally on the battlefield gains trample. Ooh! That's worth it. I might put that on my ally deck. I'm not sure. It's worth it. And now we're at the uncommons. We have Processor Assault. Has additional cost to put a card an opponent owns from exile into the graveyard. Deals 5 damage to target creature. That's going in my Eldrazi. Oh, I didn't show you. I got so excited I didn't show you. There it is. The glare. My mom is getting me a camera, an HD camera, and hopefully it's gonna be good. All right, Grip of Desolation, exile target creature and land. Ooh, I like it. Hopefully you can see that. Ruin, ru. I feel like I'm a fucking foreign person. Ruination Guide. Other colorless creatures you control get +1/+0. It's a 3-drop. That's not bad. I might put that in there too. I definitely gotta remake some of my decks because these newer cards that I'm getting, so good. Drowner of Hope. When Drowner of Hope enters the battlefield, put 2/1/1s and sacrifice and Eldrazi's going tap target creature. I've seen this before, I think. There you go. Land and an octopus. Still no planeswalkers, but we got 4 left. 4 left. All right. We'll open this guy first. Come on, planeswalker. Or expedition. Come on, buddy. Alright, let me see. I've seen this. Another plummet. Okay. Discard two cards. Goblin, who I've seen you. Yep, I've seen plenty of you. Another one of the Undo champions, that's good. Flying Vigilance, okay. Oh, yep, okay. And, okay. Oh, we're at the uncommons now. Royal's Retribution deals 5 damage, divided as you choose among any number of target attacking or blocking creatures. It's pretty good. A little costly, but it's pretty good. Oh god. Jotty's Offshoot. Defender, landfall. Whenever land enters the battlefield, you gain a life. Might go in that life in my life game that I want to make. Carrier Thrall. When it dies, put a 1/1 colorless Eldrazi. Okay. Doesn't seem like it should be ever used. Radiant Flames deals X damage to each creature, where X is the number of colors of mana spent to cast Radiant Flames. So it costs 3. So ideally, if you're using a tri-mana, oh damn, if you're using a tri-mana, you would want to use all 3 colors to deal 3 damage to each creature. Wait, whoa. That's each creature as in my creatures too. Why? Why would I want to do that? Why? Disgusted. I got an object. Ooh! Oh my. Oh my god. I think I got the best token in the world right now. A 10/10 Eldrazi. Gonna cherish this one. 'Cause this one feels like it's gonna be a special card. Oh man, that was a good one. That was a good one. I like that. Alright, let's go. Let's go with the blue girl next. What are we? 22 minutes in. Oof. Sludge crawler. Yeah, I've seen you. Ooh, I got another needle. I got another needle drone. Yay! I like the needle drones. Okay. Got a. What is it? Okay. So I got Skyline Cascade. Eldrazi Sky Spire. Okay. It's not bad. I've seen you enough times. Ruin Processor. A Bone Splinters. Yes, those are useful. Okay. Worm. Human Warrior Landfall. The Hand. Cool. We're at the rares. I mean, uncommons. Draenor's Emissary. Oh, I've seen this card before. I've seen this before. I actually have this in my ally deck. I might put another one in. Who knows? Alright, Molten Nursery. Whenever you cast a colorless spell, Molten Nursery deals 1 damage to target creature or player. Ooh, that's going in my void. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. All right, Desolation Twin. Yep, I've seen this before. It's only a rare, which is, well, you'd figure something like this would be mythic rare. That's the card that allows me to put a 10/10 colorless Eldrazi creature. Royal Spout. Put target creature on top of its owner's library. It's the foil of the pack. And I got a Plains and a Dragon. Plains and a Dragon. Okay. My back's hurting from sitting in this chair for a little while. Let's do. Are you a girl? I don't know. Is this a girl? Looks like a girl. Could be a guy, though. I don't right. Okay. So minus x minus 0. Okay. Cool. You may put a land card from your hand on the battlefield. Oh, so if I got like a lot of land in my hand, Swell of Growth will be really good. Ooh. This is only good if you're playing up against an Eldrazi, though. Okay. Well, yeah. Target creature. Oh, yep, that's gonna be useful. I've seen you. I've seen you. I've seen you before. Yeah, I've seen you. I actually use that card. Eldrazi Devastator. Trample. 8, 9. Whoa. And it cost 8. And now we're at the uncommons. Come on, Planeswalker! Or an expedition, please. Brood Monitor. When it enters the battlefield, put 3 1/1s. And, yep. Costs 6. I probably won't be putting this card in. Costs way too much. Crumble to Dust, we've already seen this. Horribly Awar? I have no idea. It looks like this. And there you go. I've seen this card already. I actually have this in my Eldrazi deck. I just have no idea how to pronounce it. Painful Truce. You draw X cards and you lose X life, where X is a number of color. Why would anyone want to play? I don't know. I don't know why anyone would want to play that. I mean, yeah, you can draw up to 3 cards, but you're also got the chance of losing 3 life just to draw 3 cards. No. No. It looks like this. If I didn't show you already. Nope. Not happening. So, last pack, last chance. Please. Planeswalker for an expedition. Eldrazi Processor. There's battlefield. When you put there. Do return creature to hand. Sacrifice another creature. Okay. I'm itchy. Yep. Seen that enough. Okay. I've seen that enough. Okay. Yep. Well, another champion. Gideon's Reproach deals 4 damage to target attacking or blocking creature. Okay, that's going in a deck. I mean, in a, yeah, yeah, deck somewhere. Vestige of Immortal. Oh, I've seen that before. And, okay. We're at the uncommons and rares. Oh, please, for the love of God. Alright, Roiling Thunder deals X damage divided as you choose among any number of target creatures and/or players. Okay, there you go. I might put that in something, I'm not sure yet though. Skitterskin, Eldrazi Drone can't be block, can't, Skitterskin can't block, and you can regenerate it only if you control another colorless, and it costs 4. Adverse conditions. Tap up to 2 target creatures. Those creatures don't untap during the next untap step. Put a 1/1 Eldrazi. Yeah, it costs 4. I'm trying so hard not to look at the next card. Oh no, this is my rare. Oh no. This is my rare. Ah, okay. It's, oh god. Akum Hellkite. It's got Landfall. Whenever land enters the battlefield, deals one damage to target creature or player. If that land is a mountain, deals two to that creature or player instead. Looks like this. And with that being my rare, I know I don't have a chance of getting anything else, but I'm gonna look anyways. Yep, it's just a forest and an Eldrazi Scorning. No planeswalkers. So I still have yet to open a planeswalker or an expedition. It's a little disappointing. I bought 9 packs for $30 and I didn't get a planeswalker or an expedition. Oh man. Whew, it's a little disappointing. But some of you magic people will probably be like, yo, some of the cards you got are pretty good. Well, money-wise, at least. So I hope y'all enjoyed. Hope your hopes weren't crushed like mine were. And I'll see you all in the next one.